Hey everyone, Thorn and Smash here, resident Apex Predator, and today I wanted to go over Apex Legends Fight or Fright mode and how to win games in it. So if you could go ahead and leave me a like and subscribe, that would mean a ton, and let's go ahead and just dive right into the video. The first thing that we want to note is that this game is going to take place on the original King's Canyon. That means we're going to have Skulltown, it means that we're going to have Relay, Thunderdome, all that. There's going to be no map room. It's going to take us back to how it was originally, and I think that's a great step, and it really brings back nostalgic of last year's Halloween event. They've also added a ton of new gameplay elements, so we're going to go over that and how you can use those to your advantage in winning the game. Now, another great feature that Respawn has added this year is the fact that if you get two downed teammates, you get something called a pet prowler, which I think is a fantastic addition. Basically, once they're down, you'll get a notification that you have a prowler pet active, and then this little buddy of yours will come in and it'll help keep zombies off and also attack enemy players. It's a great feature added and really helps if you lose some teammates, and they also come with cool names like Spot or Other. And I really think that is a great addition and it's really fun. However, some of them are named Licky Pants. I'm not really sure how that even happened. Hey Respawn. What? Isn't this game fucking E for everyone? What the fuck, guys? Another great feature they've added this year for the zombies is the fact that you can now wall run and double jump. For any veteran of Titanfall 2, they're going to know what wall running is. Basically, you run at a wall parallel, you jump up, and you can continue to run across it. This also applies to a double jump feature, where when you're in the peak of your jump, you're going to want to jump one more time and it'll boost it. What I see a lot of players do though, is they'll run on one wall and then simply slide off. What you want to do is as you're running across the wall, at the height of the wall, you want to jump, go to the middle of where you're at, and then hit the double jump to land on the other wall. You can continue momentum and run across entire sections by simply going left to right, left to right, and it makes it very hard to hit you. Continuing our trend of great things that Respawn has added is the fact that everyone that spawns into the game will be given a gold knockdown shield, which is great. It means if you're downed, you don't have to rely on your teammates and you can respawn yourself. And hey, you still have all your alive teammates, but that's not all. Your zombies can now bring you back, and they even get very super cool animations that haven't been seen before to do that. It's really a great function, as the zombies can move at 2 times the normal speed of a player, and they can also one-shot most people in their way to bring you back. It can absolutely change the tide of a battle. There have been numerous times where I've been down and my teammates who are zombies have been able to rush in, get people out of the way, and bring me back so that we can continue the fight and push it back onto them. Now, the last big thing that they've added for the zombies in this mode is that typically you will respawn within about 100 feet of your remaining teammates. However, for the last few circles, you'll actually drop it from the sky like last year's mode, which can be huge. It allows you to survey the battlefield. You can see where your team is positioned. You can see where the remaining teams are positioned, and it allows you to drop right behind them, like I did with this Octane, so you can yeet them into the circle. This can be absolutely critical for a team success and team win, because remember, as a zombie, even if you die, you're probably coming back in about 15 to 20 seconds in the later rounds. So it is absolutely critical that you use the ability that you can continually respawn and see the battlefield to help your remaining teammates so that they don't have to risk dying to the fight. Now, when you're alive, you most likely want to play Apex like you normally do. However, you do want to be aware of the zombies on the enemy's team. You don't want to get too close, as they can one or two shot you most times. What I like to do is hit them with a hemlock or a scout rifle, and each time you kill the zombie, it takes longer for them to respawn. So what you can do is try to get that respawn timer for them to about 20 seconds, and once you've killed them, you can push knowing you've got a 3-on-1 advantage, and it's going to be a while before they respawn. Do be aware though that the last person on the enemy team will have a gold knockdown shield. Overall, I am very enthusiastic with what Respawn has been able to do with this new Halloween mode. They built upon the foundations of last year's mode and made it even better in my opinion. Adding things like the Titanfall jumping and wall running was a huge step in the right way for a game that sometimes has felt a little stale. I wasn't a big fan of the last event that we had with the aftermarket collection, so to see this, I'm really enthusiastic about where they're going to go in the future. As always, there are a ton of different variables that will lead you to win the game, and not everything in this video will help you get that win, but I hope it leads you in the right direction and just makes you aware of what you can do, whether you're playing as a zombie or as a regular character. It's still up to you at the end of the day to decide how you want to win that game. But like I said, thank you again for coming into this video, and if you could leave a like and subscribe, that would mean a ton to me. I'm new to YouTube and I'm trying to grow my channel, so it just lets me know that I'm going in the right direction. I also stream Monday through Sunday on Twitch, so if you ever want to play, I start at 10 a.m. Pacific time and I go until around 3:30, and I'm always down to play with new people. I run every day an open lobby system, so feel free to stop by and play some games, and maybe I can help you in person. Until then, keep winning your games, Apex Legends, and I'll see you in the Outlands.